And we're back. Welcome back, everyone. As you may have noticed at the end of the last bit, I'm not sure if it'll be a split video there or just another part of the same video, but as you may have noticed just now, the game crashed when I tried to save it. Fortunately, it also saved. So, we finished a couple of side quests on the Citadel, and I've been going for quite a while now, so what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to take us to the point where we'll be starting the next session, and then I'm gonna end it there. And that location will be the local cluster, which is basically where Earth is, and Sol System. And we are going to land on a very specific planet. Well, not really a planet. And you have probably already figured it out. Yeah, I don't know why it works so well there, but yeah, like I said, for some reason, various snowstorms really hit my frame rate hard.
Message for you, Commander. Just came in over a secure channel.
Someone else.
This is Admiral Goku.
This is important. Pay attention.
The ones killed by the Thresher War. Damn, I hope you get this message. It was a group called Cerberus. An Alliance Black Ops organization. Top secret, highest level security clearance. They vanished a few months ago. Dropped right off the grid. Nobody knew where they went or what they were up to. They've gone completely rogue, Shepard. They're conducting illegal genetic experiments trying to create some kind of super soldier. I don't have any proof, but I found the coordinates for one of their research worlds. I'm uploading them with this message. They're completely out of control. Somebody needs to stop them. I've done my part. Now it's up to you. This is probably the last you'll hear from me. Cerberus is after me now. I need to disappear before they find me.
Yeah. Now, for those of you who've played Mass Effect 2, then you know Cerberus is important, and for those of you wondering, I do remember a tiny bit from Mass Effect 2, and I have played these quests before, so I know the gist of what happens, but the specific details are gonna escape me. Which will make it kind of interesting, because I know basically the long and short of what happens, but the exact details I won't remember. And now we are going to land on the moon. Frame rate's dropping a bit. This is kind of annoying. And this is technically an official Alliance operation, so we should technically bring Ashley and Caden, but let me think about this. We're actually going to bring Tally as one person, because we're actually going to bring Tally and Ashley, because we are trying to shut down a VI. And since we're trying to shut down a VI, someone who's good with tech would be nice. And Ashley's a pretty good tank, though not nearly as good as Rex, so she can serve as another of the frontliners. I think they'll be good for this. Alliance training ground. We're going to head straight for the training ground, since I can't be bothered to search that debris here. This is one of the cases where the area can be annoyingly large, depending on what you consider small and what you consider large. I call this medium size, but it's kind of annoying to have to get there. Because it feels like you're driving for a while sometimes. Which can get on the nerves of some people. It doesn't annoy me too much, but I can see how it would be annoying to certain people. Let's just put it that way. So, we are going to head towards that facility. It appears the AI has control of their defense turrets. Fortunately for us, the Mako can take a bit of a pounding, so we can afford to get hit a bit, if it's necessary. Bit of a stutter there. Not really sure what was going on. Sorry. But their defense turrets are out of commission now. So we can just go in a circle and take the buildings out one at a time. But before we go inside, we are going to upgrade our squad. And we need to equip ourselves for facing synthetics. And we will change out Melinda's implant for a more appropriate one. And finally, we have a set of medium armor we can wear. For anything else, we want to get our people equipped for this fight. Ashley can go into her new set of heavy armor. Tally has a better shotgun. And a better pistol. And we have Quarian armor. It's yellow and doesn't look very good, but cosmetics aren't a huge concern for us. And we are going to be switching to the damage humans. We're going to be switching to the damaged synthetics ammunition. And there's a better shotgun we can give Ashley. We'll give you a combat scanner. Have a combat scanner there. was armor piercing. You can have weapon stability. Tungsten rounds, definitely. What about your armor? Battery 3 will give you better shields. You see, Tali can have tungsten rounds. I'll give my pistol photon rounds to bypass shields. We're not going to give you that. I'm going to give that one to Shepard. Where is it? Shield modulator. Five. And Tali can have the four. Because we're a vanguard, and we will be getting up close and personal a lot more than our squad, so we need the extra shield strength more than they do. To destroy the conduits in all the sectors. So I'm going to drop a hard save. And I've been recording roughly somewhere between an hour and a half and 2 hours, I think. So I'd say this is a good place to end the recording once Ashley stops doing that. So, this has been DarkPhoenix Ninja 92, and you've been watching Let's Play Mass Effect. Thank you so much for watching, and next time we will delve into these rogue VI controlled bases and take them out. See you then.